Webs. It is I, the Autobot, and I am back for yet another Iron Man 2 toy review. Today, we're going to be reviewing this guy, the Iron Man Mark V armor. Now, from what we can tell in the two trailers, that this is a portable version of the Iron Man armor. It's not nearly as tough, but it gives him the majority of his Iron Man abilities, such as the Repulsor Blast, then the superhuman strength in this armor. So, he has that whenever he needs it. Now, this guy does come with a briefcase that is the one that looks like it's what is supposed to be carrying his armor. And there's kind of, you know, the armor detailing in there. Thing I don't get about that is why he gets it. I mean, I would like this better, I would think, if they came out with just a Tony Stark action figure, because you do get a little hand, let's see, a hand to use on this, to attach to his hand so you can actually hold this. Let me show you real quick. So you get the hand in there. And it doesn't really hold on all too well. The only places where it really gets a grip is in between the index finger and the thumb. Other than that, it doesn't really hold on. And you can only attach it to one hand, and it's the left hand. So you take it off. Here's the hand right here. You put the hand on, which is giving me some trouble. I don't know. There we go. And now it's on there. And now you have his briefcase. And you may notice, and it's also a rocket launcher. Woo! Little blue button on this side, where you see clearly stands out. You push it and yeah, two missiles. I usually don't keep them in there. I usually just display it sitting in front of him like this. So you can do that. So yes, let's get back to the figure. Now this figure does seem to have a certain Silver Centurion feel to it. Hold on a second. Plug his fist back in. Like I said, it does seem to have a very Silver Centurion feel to it, with the silver accents and then just the red, so maybe that's kind of what he's going for as well, but it's a very nice armor. It looks skin tight. It looks like it folds up just the way that it has kind of the grooves in here. Makes it look like it just folds right back up into a briefcase, I guess. Let's move on to articulation. Head rotates a full 360 degrees. Pops off like all the Iron Man toys. Now, the one thing about this toy that I do not like, that's as far as you can go with his arm. Because of the way these are sculpted in, you don't get any movement in there, so it really bothers me about that. You can't get a full 360 degree rotation. Arm bends very stiffly too. It's a very stiff joint in there, and rotates, and the hand obviously rotates as well. Hips, you got the Hasbro janky hips, and this guy, once again, he just seems to have a real problem with getting these turned. You have to, like, I don't even want to do it because I'm afraid I might break him. One more thing, his legs, I don't know why, just the plastic that they use, like, the leg itself is okay, but the joint in here is a very loose plastic, so you get this going on, and it really bothers me that that's like that. I was really hoping I could love this guy, but he is by far one of my least favorite of the line. And it's just for things that, maybe it's just QC control on my part, but whatever. Hip. You also have a waist joint in here. Very loose, like the Mark VI, but it gets done. It stays in place when you need it to. And you have 2 points of articulation in the knee here. And you have a miniature knee scoop of death on here, so that's always fun. And once again, you have the very limited ankle swivel, ankle joint. So yes, that's all I'm going to say about the figure. It's a nice display figure, I guess. You know, you can't get him into a repulsor blast pose. That's got to be, like, off to the front. And his head turns and gets his arm in there and kind of, you know. Then you can kind of get a repulsor blast pose, but it's not really the best. Now let's talk about the bland stand. There, we talked about it. And then we'll go over his cards. Hold on a second. Let's get them off here. And here are his cards. Put them together. And you got a 3D armor. I'm really hoping they get that side up sometime soon so we can actually figure out what we're supposed to do with these codes. Like, I'm hoping we can get, like, an online Hall of Armor, and then we can swap out parts, but who knows. But yes, that's about it for this figure. I'm not sure if I could recommend this guy, simply because of his arm limits. I'm sure you could go in there and, you know, cut out the part that keeps it from moving, but then you would be ruining the toy. He looks good. If you were to do that, you would ruin the toy, I would think. This is the Autobot with the Iron Man Mark V armor, signing off, reminding you all, until that day, till all are one.